Today, I'm going to be making a video on how to start a successful YouTube channel. I know many people have problems with this. I was one of them. Still am, kind of. I'm going to give you some tips on how to get started, keep your channel growing, and how to get a YouTube channel going. So, I've wrote down a couple of ideas of what's worked for me. And I'm going to share them with you guys, so maybe I can help you out. Number one, good thumbnails. I use a thumbnail editor app. You know, write text on your pictures, get a cool picture for your video. It's really cool. I like to do it. It's a good way to get views, per se. It helps make your video stand out. Helps them stand out. Putting these in your videos can help, cannot necessarily help you, but it can help other viewers to be like, oh, that person reminds me of so-and-so. Like, I like their videos. I do all my thumbnails kind of same, so people will recognize me. So that's tip number one. Tip number two is tagging your videos. I've never really seen much of a change in this for my videos, but I still do it. So I made a video a couple weeks ago that did pretty good. It was a winter pond bass fishing. I think it got about 130 something views on it. I did tags like big bass, catching big bass, how to catch big bass, winter bass fishing. I included some of the lures I used. Tagging your videos can help you if you're a bigger YouTuber, because it will help rank your videos in the search box. The reason most people don't get a lot of views is because their videos aren't ranking on YouTube, but it hasn't really helped me any, but it's definitely out there. It's always an option. Sub for sub. Many people say, don't do this, don't do this. Well, guess what? Don't listen to them, because they're wrong. It helps. It works. It helps me. It's helped me in the past 6 months grow my YouTube channel. It really has. It's pretty easy. I know you want to find small YouTubers, comment, like their video, watch all of it, comment, nice video, man. I subbed, check me out. Trying to grow my channel or help each other out, you know, comment that. Most likely they'll comment back and say, hey man, thanks for subbing, I'll check you out. And most of the time they'll sub back to you. Also, by doing that, you can really gain subscribers quickly and efficiently. And it can help you gain views. That's it's helped me tremendously. I don't see why people say it's not good. It really helps me. It's helped some people I know, some other smaller YouTubers that I know through Facebook and things. They've really set off their channel by doing this. If you're a social media geek like I am, you know, there's some buddies of mine have came up with a group name on YouTube or on Facebook. It's called Fishing YouTube. You can join there. Everybody posts their videos there. You can gain subs from them. Kind of becomes friends with them too. It's kind of what I've done. I've became Facebook friends with some of them, but they're all nice people. Give them a check out. YouTube or Facebook.com. Go to Facebook on your phone. Fishing YouTube is what it's called. There's some good people in that group, and they'll really help you out. Now, how I got started, I'm 16, so back in 2013, I started my YouTube channel. Now, I did some goofy videos here and there that weren't really, I'd say, really good, but they were never really good. They weren't about fishing, they were just goofing around videos. they were just for goof-offs, but I started there, and I started to get older, and I was big into fishing when I was little. I never really had the camera gear. I never had money to really buy it. I got a job last year and I was able to buy a GoPro camera, and I got a computer for my birthday. So I'm able to now edit videos, and I'm not saying you couldn't ever edit videos before, but helps me to get content better. And I figured out maybe if I'm watching the other big YouTubers, fishing YouTubers, John B, Flair, Lunkers TV, watching them, I thought, hey, they're doing the same similar stuff I am. I might can be like them. But I've always never, I never had hope for it. But I took a couple of months to gather some information, really do some research on how to become successful on YouTube. And it's gonna take a while. It takes you a while, but you're gonna eventually get there. Eventually you will set off and be awesome. It hasn't really happened to anybody I know right now, because everybody I know right now is anywhere from 200 to 600, 700 subscribers. Most people will tell you that your YouTube channel won't take off till you hit about 6 or 10K subs, but subs doesn't matter. I have 307 subs, but I only get 100 to 150 views a video, if even that sometimes. Not everybody's gonna watch your videos, but they're always there. Camera gear. Now, I mentioned a while ago that I use GoPro. I have two GoPros. I have the GoPro Hero 5 and the GoPro Hero 3. I've made some of my older video fishing. Some of my first 5 or 6 fishing videos I made were with the Hero 3, and I found that the quality wasn't all that well, and I wanted to upgrade and do a little bit better. So I saved up my money for about a year and bought the Hero 5. It's a great camera. I recommend it if you're fishing, YouTube, anything, any outdoor sports, I recommend it. The Hero 5 is completely waterproof. It's got GPS, Wi-Fi, everything. It's so easy to connect to your phone to get your videos, make your videos. Sit-down videos are another good thing for like this time of the year, you know, December, January, when I can still do some fishing, but this past couple of weeks, these past 3 weeks, the temperature really dropped and all the ponds are frozen solid, but they're not frozen enough to make any ice fishing videos because they're not safe enough. But so I can't do any fishing, so I made a couple of sit-down videos and I plan on it. It's supposed to rain the rest of this week and be real nasty and draggy, but I'm gonna keep doing these sit-down videos to keep everyone entertained. They're a really good thing too. Another thing I see YouTubers do is they'll collaborate. Now, I don't have the ability to do this because no one in my area where I live, I know that I can find, makes videos. And granted that I'm 16, I'm still in high school, so I can't really venture out and go on trips and make really cool videos. I can stick to pond fishing for a couple more years, or one more year until I can graduate and everything, but that's my tips I have for you. One of the things I've also just learned over time is you just gotta get out and do what you wanna do. It's not gonna happen overnight, and it's not gonna happen over 2 years. It's gonna take a while, but if you stick with it, it'll all come together. Thanks for watching. If I missed anything, I'm sorry, this is my first video on this. I'll try to make an updated version. But I'm gonna do some more sit-down videos this week. Thanks for watching. Let's roll the outro. Jake the Snake out.